Hello students, today we discuss uniform circular motion. We know that the velocity of an object can change by changing the magnitude of velocity or direction of velocity or both. However, if there is any change in its velocity, we can say there is an acceleration for that moving body. Let us discuss some situation of the changing velocity. Suppose a body is moving through a rectangular track like this. A body is moving through a rectangular path A, B, C, D. Suppose the body is starting from this point, then it is moving through this rectangular path. Once it completes a rectangular path, with a constant speed, the object is moving through this rectangular path. And once it completes a rectangular path, we can say 4 times the direction of the object change. 4 times the direction of motion of the object change. When it reaches at each corner, if it want to continue the rectangular path, it want to change its direction. So once it complete a rectangular path, the 4 times the object change its directions. 4 times the object change its directions. But it moving with a constant speed. So we can say the magnitude of velocity is not changing, but there is a change in direction of velocity. Now see, another situation, suppose the object is moving through a hexagonal track. It has 6 sides, a hexagonal track. Once the object completes a hexagonal track like this, it is moving through this hexagonal path and complete. Once it complete a hexagonal track, we can say the 6 times the direction of motion is changes. 6 times the direction of motion changes. Even the object is moving with a constant magnitude of velocity, the direction of velocity changes by 6 times. Now suppose if the object is moving through a octagonal track, it have 8 sides. Once the object is moving through this hexagonal track and it completes one round. When it completes one round, we can say how many times its direction of velocity changes? 8 times. 8 times the direction of velocity change. See, the magnitude of velocity is not changing, only the direction of velocity changes by 8 times. Imagine the number of sides of this track is increasing. If the number of track is increasing, what happened? The length of the side, the length of the side is decreases, and the change in direction of motion is increases. If you are increasing the number of sides by infinite times, the length of the sides decreases to a point. The length of the side decreases to very small, and it become look like as a point. Then the path look like as a circular path. This path of this motion will look like as a circular track. So the circular track having infinite sides, we can say infinite side, and each side having a very small length can be considered as a point. So we can say, Once the object is moving through a circular track, how many times the direction of motion changes? It has infinite number of sides. So we can say infinite times the direction of motion changes. So even though it is moving with a constant magnitude of velocity, it having an acceleration. It having an acceleration because of a change in direction of velocity. So such A motion can be called as a uniform circular motion. A uniform circular motion. Actually, a uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion. Even if the magnitude of velocity is as a constant, keep as a constant, but as the direction is changes continuously, we can say it is an accelerated motion. So that type of motion is known as uniform circular motion. It's a motion of an object through a circular path with a constant speed. It is usually an accelerated motion. Every uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion. Now consider a uniform circular motion. Here we have a circular track of radius r, and an object is moving through this circular path with a magnitude of velocity v. The magnitude of velocity is v and the radius of the circular track is r. Now say t is the time taken by the object to complete one circular path. The t is the time taken by the object to complete one circular path. Now we can write the expression for the velocity of this object as velocity v is equal to, v is equal to, once it complete a circular track, it travel a distance of 2 pi r, 2 pi r. And if t is the time taken to complete the circular path, we can write an expression for its velocity as v is equal to 2 pi r by t. V is equal to 2 pi r by t. Here v is the speed, the magnitude of velocity, or the speed of the object, and r is the radius of this circular track, and t is the time taken for the object to complete this circular path. Now let us discuss an example for uniform circular motion. Suppose we are taking a thread of length L and a stone is tied at the end of the thread, and we are holding at one end of this thread and rotating with a constant speed into a circular path. The stone is tied at the end of a string and we are holding the other end of the string and rotating it into a circular path with a constant speed. Now we can say the stone is in uniform circular motion. Suppose once we are releasing this thread at any instant, suppose when the stone is reached here and we are just releasing the thread, what you can observe is that the stone is trying to continue its direction of motion. When the stone is here, this is actually the direction of motion of the stone along this tangent of the circular path. So the stone will move along this path. Once it releases from this point, the stone will move along this path. And suppose we are continuing and the rotation, and suppose we are releasing the stone from some other point from here, when it reached here, if you are releasing the stone, you can see the stone will move along this path, along this tangent down here. And we are repeating this experiment. Suppose we are releasing the stone from here and it will move along this path. If you are releasing from here, it will move along this path. So it shows that in uniform circular motion, at every point, when the stone is releasing, it always tries to continue its path. From this point, this is actually the direction of the stone. Once we are releasing the stone from this point, the stone is trying to move along this path. If you are releasing from this point, it will move along this path, because at this point, this is actually the direction of the stone. At this point, this is the direction of the stone. At this point, this is the direction of the stone. Actually, it shows that in a uniform circular motion, at every point, the direction of motion changes. So the magnitude of velocity, even as a constant. As the direction of velocity changes, it possesses some acceleration. Due to the change in velocity, it have an acceleration. Some more examples for uniform circular motions are the motion of an artificial satellite in its orbit, or the motion of moon and earth in its orbit is almost uniform circular motions. Now let us discuss a numerical questions from circular motion, uniform circular motion. Here we have an artificial satellite is moving in a circular orbit of radius 42,250 km, 42,250 km. Suppose this is our satellite, it is moving through a circular orbit of radius 42,250 km. We have to calculate its speed if it takes 24 hours to revolve around the Earth. The time taken to complete the circular path is equal to 24 hours. We want to find what is the velocity of the satellite. Here, first we are writing the radius is equal to 42,250 km. Time is equal to 24 hours. And what is the equation for velocity? Velocity is equal to 2 pi r by t. Velocity is equal to, this is the equation, velocity is equal to 2 pi r by t. Substitute 2 into pi is equal to 3.14 into radius 42,250 by 24. Once you are doing, we get the value of velocity as v is equal to 11,055.4 km/h. That is the velocity of this satellite in its orbit. Thank you.